When I was a child, in addition to playing paper dolls and, you know, the things you do when you're tiny, I always wanted to play school. And luckily I had friends who liked to play school. Mm-hmm. So in the summer, we played school all summer. Poor things didn't have a chance to rest because, and guess who was the teacher?
I bet you were.
Yes. Someone had a blackboard in our community. I remember a little portable blackboard, and we just had a good time playing school. Something happened, and it was really kind of a bad time for me in a way. In the 60s, in the late 60s, there were walkouts on the part of Latino students from the Denver Public Schools because it was their feeling they just weren't getting the attention and the respect that they should get from teachers. And I think that was true because even I, from time to time, heard derogatory remarks by teachers, not many. Thank God, not many really had that attitude. But when there was a walkout, they really expected all of us with Latino names to walk out with the students and the leaders. Well, that was the first year I was made an administrator, and I was down at the administration building. So I really wanted to support the walkout, but I didn't dare. I thought I would lose my job because there were no administrators out there walking. But that was really a difficult time because I suffered not only because I felt guilty, but some of the people leading the activist group were angry with me because I just didn't walk out too because they felt I would have had more influence. We were able to get money from the government to do bilingual education. We took the money thinking, well, we'll help the children who hear Spanish at home and we'll help the other children learn Spanish. So we did it in a kind of a bilingual way. Because we didn't have the need that we have at this time, you see. So that was our aim, to have everybody come out bilingual, Latinos as well as all other children. And so in the school where we had the bilingual education, we had about half Latinos and half not Latinos, but we worked with the Spanish language. So it was kind of an advantage in a way because they had that opportunity to learn the language. I think you still have to remain true to want to help your ethnic group. If they're having problems, and they certainly are now, we have so many difficulties now. So I started being active with LAEF when it was just a small organization, but I thought it was so important because it helped young people go to college. La Raza came about because we wanted so much over the years to become a part of the Mile High United Way, and Mi Casa tries to take in people, help them get back into the workforce or remain in the workforce. And well, I think from my parents I inherited the idea of just don't quit, you know, just stick in there and put one foot ahead of the other and just work with it and do your best. I think that's what sustains you, and I think having faith in God and the good upbringing of your family and people who support you. I think there's always somebody who's going to be standing behind you and help you if you get in trouble. So I think that's what keeps you going. You have to seek and welcome mentors, even if they're not of your ethnic group. Don't hesitate to get help, because we all need help in this world. And I think the other thing is do your best. I always loved school, and I still like being, you know, learning. And I hope that people think of learning as being a lifelong experience. Well, I always liked legislation and lobbying. I thought citizens ought to take more part in what happens in our government. And so I joined because there was an active legislative committee. And then I was asked to be on the national board. And so I have organized a group of 30 women, all Latinas who are busy people, and we do our lobbying by telephone. So ARP really is actually working with the business roundtable and a union group to try to say we've got to do something about health care for everybody. And I think just listening to people and being pleasant, you know, that goes a long way. Get an education, that's the most important thing. You just cannot progress in this world unless you get an education. Don't give up, try hard, make good grades. You know, people would say, oh, how did you do that? Well, I made good grades. I wasn't dating a lot, and I wasn't going to the sorority house, so I could study. I said, I'm going to make straight A's. Well, I just hope that they think I did more good than harm. I guess that one hopes for that. And if I've been of any inspiration, I hope it will help other young women of the Latino community and others.